I don't think there's a congressman, someone said I'm not listening. Gosh, I think I listened here more than I talked. I'd never been to anything where the politician didn't dominate the conversation and take up 90% of the microphone time. Certainly, you know, to try to keep track of the phone calls that are coming in and the emails. I don't even look at my Facebook, to be honest. It would be too, it's too easy to say something nasty on Facebook. So I think I have listened. And I hear, I'd be careful, you know, not to jump to conclusions. But after 21 of this, I hear the anger in some people's voices. I hear the anger. And at first I thought the anger was against me. And I think that anger is probably more directed towards your state government. It's directed towards Donald Trump. So that's just my interpretation, is that this anger, people are, frankly, there's some people just angry and don't believe that Donald Trump got elected. They were promised something else, and here he is. So, you know, we were taught these phases of death and dying in medical school, and the first two phases are this anger and denial, and there's people that are in that situation right now. So listening and understanding are two things that I would find myself in. And just because I listen and understand doesn't mean that we're going to always agree. But I've tried to remain respectful. What I wish, what my hope is that we can turn this anger into a common goal, to common passions, to turn it into how can we get this country, this state moving forward. I bet if we would talk together that you would find your goals and my goals are very similar. That I want a stronger economy, you want a stronger economy. You want more accessible, affordable health care. That is absolutely my goal. And I do think I know something about health care. So this bill is our generation of the next generation. What we think will make it better. Much like Medicare, if we don't do some things to tweak it, it's going to go broke. This exchange is going broke through no fault of my own. I truly wish it was working, and I could have started working on tax reform in January. So my goal, my prayer, is that we can start putting the anger aside and move to the next step, which is coming up with common goals and working together for the better of our communities. Thank you for taking the time out of your day to come today. I do appreciate it. I don't take it for granted. Thanks again to Don and the Chamber for opening up this facility. Thanks for the radio stations, the newspaper here. Lots of communities, the press doesn't come to these. I don't know why. But I think it's important to hear what you have to say as me. So thank you to the press for developing this professional relationship. I have a greater respect and affirmation for them as well. Everybody have a great day. Thanks for coming.